Thank you. shit behind all this is
he got brushed back. Andy put one over in the bleachers over there.
I guess we're just doing this to get Grand Paul and then start back.
Another one. Maybe. Yep. We'll come back. There you go.
American, like the war's right. That's yesterday. I need it because my
you need it?
On
it.
Oh.
I think it's down there and get some close-up stuff, you think?
Yeah, I mean, if you want. They're going to get done. They're about, I think they're done, and they're going to do the media period of it.
Okay.
Hey, I got some left.
I think we can get the backdrop.
Scoreboard and everything.
Yeah. All right, you ready?
Yeah. I'm moving my little brother into college. He's going to UKU, first one in his family.
Really? That's
so,
cool.
So, yeah, that's he was my original match of big brothers.
UKU is, I think, doing well. I've got several friends that have gone there.
Seems like him for some Vincent. Seems like he's really got some big aspirations and big things ahead.
Yeah, I think that's great. So, so you have how many that you're talking for?
Five now.
Five.
Yep, it was supposed to be one, but then it just kept going.
You helped them through the big brothers, or they actually lived with
him? One full-time lived. I have custody of him. The other ones, he started to get older. No, that's an even younger one who's going into his junior year, just started his junior year high school. And then with all of them, I told him, I said, hey, you go to college, you get through the first year, show me you're committed, I'll pay for the rest. So it's pretty
that's
amazing.
Awesome. That's great.
And they're all, they all grew up in there.
See, what's amazing is the whole system's leaving them behind, but with some assistance and help, they'll thrive and do well. I was in Philadelphia at a school called Boys Latin School. All African-American, all broken homes, really, really poor section of town. Every one of those young men comes up and looks you in the eye and shakes your hand. Every one of them goes out. They graduate 100 every year. Every one of them has 4 years of life. But they also teach them citizenship, and they teach them law and order and everything. They teach them the stuff they weren't getting at home.
Yep. No, I mean, that's, and those are the things. My little brother's moms get their bullshit, welfare, or whatever else, goes towards TVs or towards something else. That doesn't get them ahead. I've seen a small cycle. Exactly. So that's why I try and, every time I meet them, life is.
Yeah, that's what you're thinking.
You know, we had contests when they were younger. Whoever knows the most names gets people to go to lunch. You know, it's those things that really develop in guys.
No, I think that's great. I think there are a lot of good things going on. A lot of times we aren't capturing those good stories because we have so many bad stories and things. We aren't seeing the good things that are happening, you know. They have something in Louisville called Lincoln Scholarships, Lincoln Foundation. And it's all by philanthropy. And they give away 100 sort of scholarships every year for the kids.
It's amazing. And that gives them a step.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming by.
Do you want to go under?
If you want to go to the dugout, we can do that. Or we can go up under.
Yeah.
Or we can go up under.
Okay, perfect.
Awesome. Ren.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate it.
Great
talking
to you.
We'll be around and we'll hang out and go see some of the achievement kids.
Legends, you're a big baseball fan. A lot of people
know
about
you. When I was a kid, I always wanted to play professional baseball, but I think my only route to being on the field is through politics. But it's great being here. I grew up like a lot of kids in across America. Loving playing baseball. I played every summer, you know, until I was 18. My brother played in college. My nephew played in college. So it's cool to be out here. And we still play a charity game in Washington. Republicans play Democrats. And for the first year in 6 years, Republicans won this year.
All right. About 68 days, I believe, is the count now out from Election Day. What are things looking like?
You know, I think in Kentucky, we're trending more conservative, more Republican. And a lot of that's because the war on coal has been instigated by National Democrats, and so a lot of that blame has trickled down to Democrats here in Kentucky because the war on coal, we've lost 15,000 jobs.
In a recent stop in Louisville, Senator McConnell talked about the scope of the different political races going on in our country and in our state right now, and he said yours was one of the ones he wasn't worried about in terms of Republicans being in office. How does that make you feel?
Well, I guess we don't take anything for granted. We're leaving no stone unturned. I've done 80 town halls, and by Labor Day, I've done about 100 town halls in the last 6 months. So we're getting out, we're asking the voters what they think about. And every day I go into meetings here in Lexington, Northern Kentucky later tonight, where we ask them, what's going on in your community? What can government do to allow you to prosper more, to employ more people, to create more jobs? And I think that's what our job is, to find out how can our communities prosper more. When I'm here at the ballpark, I want them to have more people here. I want more people to come out and watch the Legends, so that's good for Lexington.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to start your hair and change up the shot? What are some things that you're doing specifically right now? How has the way you campaign changed over the past few months, and how will it continue to evolve as you get closer to Election Day?
I think it's mainly that we hold a lot of town halls. We have open questions, Republican, Democrat, Independent. If you want to come to one of our town halls, we'll answer your questions. But it's not only about answering questions, we actually seek advice. I get suggestions on different bills that we can put in place. And I'll give you an example. I was meeting with a wounded warrior the other day, and he has prosthetics. And when they went through the airport, they made him take his prosthetics off. I think we could probably do without that. For a wounded hero, maybe we could have a special card. And so when I get back to Washington, I'm going to introduce a bill that says, you know what, if you're a wounded warrior, give them a card identifying them, and they shouldn't have to take off their prosthetics, for goodness sakes.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, just that I'm still looking at and worried about how much money we spend in Washington, the deficit. We borrow $1 million a minute. And I think we need to quit sending so much money to foreign countries, paving their roads, and keep that money here at home.
Okay.
Thanks. Thank you. All right. Thanks, guys. And then,
It's iffy all day, and it's kind of just light sprinkle. I'll bet you they're playing this.